For this lesson, we'll explore a technique called simple linear regression. Part 1 of this video is an overview of the concept of a straight line, scatter plots, the symbols and terminology, and a population statistical model. Parts 2 and 3 will provide details on the actual regression technique for estimating and investigating the straight line using a sample of data. In other math courses, you've seen straight line relationships. Simple linear regression is about finding an equation for the straight line and understanding its meaning. When graphing or modeling a straight line relationship, we have two variables, x and y. X is referred to as the independent variable and goes on the horizontal axis. The other variable is y, the dependent variable. This variable goes on the vertical axis. When deciding which variable should be x and which should be y, the y should be the variable that you're interested in predicting, and the x should be something that you wouldn't typically know about a person, or more generically, an experimental unit. For example, I might want to predict a friend's shoe size. I could do this by building a model to predict shoe size based on height. So shoe size would be the dependent variable, and height would be the independent or x variable. When you first learned about straight line relationships, you probably learned it as y equals mx plus b, or also called the slope-intercept form, where m is the slope and b is the y-intercept. For this example, we see y equals 0.5x plus 2. So that means that our slope is 0.5 and our y-intercept is 2. We can calculate the slope by doing rise over run on a graph. We're doing that change in x over change in y formula. So the slope being 1/2 in our example means that if we start at any point along the graph, if I go right by 2, I'd have to go up by 1. But doing 1 over 2 is the same thing as doing 0.5 over 1. So instead we can view it like this, where if we start at a point on the graph, we could go over by 1 and up by 1/2. Like that. So over by 1 and up by 1/2. In other words, the slope is the amount y increases when x increases by 1. The y-intercept is the value of y when x is 0, or the point where the graph crosses the y-axis. In our example, a y-intercept of 2 means that y is 2 when x is 0. In statistics, we tend to write this equation slightly differently, just by rearranging these terms and using different symbols. First, we switch the order by putting the y-intercept first. We also change the symbols, so instead of using b for our y-intercept or constant term, we use beta naught, or beta subscript 0. Similarly, instead of m, we use beta 1. This allows for a more natural numbering if we add more terms to our model, such as adding a second independent variable or adding maybe an x squared term. So far, we've explored only deterministic relationships between x and y, where y can be perfectly modeled with x. This is demonstrated in this graph, with all the points falling perfectly in a straight line. When modeling real-world scenarios, this is rarely the case, and you usually will have a probabilistic relationship between x and y, meaning that there is variability or error. This is because every person is different, and some will be above average and some will be below. For example, going back to that silly shoe size example, if I were to estimate someone's shoe size based on their height, I might predict a woman who is 5'2" to have a shoe size of 6. However, due to genetics, weight, age, or any number of other factors, she could either easily be a size 5 shoe or a size 7. However, it would be very unlikely for her to be a size 10. Symbolically, we can discuss the deterministic relationship that models y based on x for a population by replacing y, which would represent each of the individual shoe sizes, with the expected value or average value of y. We write this as E of y. If we want to discuss the individual y values, we need to model the probabilistic equation. So we would add an error term, epsilon, to the model, y equals beta naught plus beta 1x. Epsilon, the error, is just the difference between the actual y values and the average y value for a given value of x. It should be noted that we will not see these exact equations much in this class, as they're population models. Our goal for now is to look at the sample estimates of these population models and parameters.